Fredman.
Here.
Alex Ferraro.
Here.
Rick Princey. Richard Amy.
Here.
Anthony Palmer.
Here.
Laura Block.
Here.
Carol Dooley.
Here.
Lisa Garvey Hall.
Here.
Charles Meehan.
Here.
Kevin Schmidt. Victoria Shepherd. Ellen Shu.
Here.
Bill Smith.
Here.
Robbie Egan. Sam Malo. I got it. Sam Malo.
Here.
Emily Strange.
Here.
Caroline Nathan.
Here.
Karen McLean.
Here.
Billy Weiss.
Here.
Ryan Woodward.
Here.
George Caswell.
Here.
David Moore.
Here.
Sarah Federo.
Here.
Candice Lopez. Kevin Lugo.
Here.
Trudy Nye.
Here.
Abdur Rahman.
Here.
Patrick Hill.
Here.
Brian Johnson.
Here.
Anthony McComiskey.
Here.
Sean Moran.
Here.
Malcolm Perry.
Here.
John Price.
Here.
Fred Stewart.
Here.
26 PMR.
Present.
ACM.
Here.
Action Against HIV/AIDS.
Here.
Allies.
Here.
Amnesty.
Here.
APO.
Here.
Art Society. Biosphere.
Here.
Black Student Union.
Here.
Bomb Squad.
Here.
Cheers.
Here.
China Club.
Here.
Service Cag. Civil War Club.
Here.
Class 2011.
Here.
Class 2012. Class 2013.
Here.
Class 2014.
Here.
Classics.
Here.
College Democrats.
Here.
College Republicans. College Against Cancer.
Here.
Dance Ensemble.
Here.
Dance Team.
Here.
Cycle Makers Christian Fellowship.
Here.
Drop the Octave.
Here.
Equestrian Club.
Here.
FCO.
Here.
Fencing Club.
Here.
Film Society. Four Scores.
Here.
Guy Baden Society. Game Club.
Here.
Hebert TV.
Here.
Gecko.
Here.
German Club.
Here.
Gettysburg Student Musical Theater, SMUT.
Here.
How to Act Humanity.
Here.
Ice Hockey. Interfaith Council.
Here, thank God.
International Affairs Association.
Here.
Fashion Club.
Here.
Japan Club.
Here.
Jazz Appreciation.
Here.
BASA.
Here.
Law and Justice.
Here.
Lutheran Student Movement. Memory Club.
Here.
Men's Rugby.
Here.
Model FEC. NAACP.
Here.
Operation Smile.
Here.
Owl Nightingale.
Here.
Peace Club.
Here.
Free Health Club.
Here.
Free Vet Club.
Here.
Sangha.
Here.
Shots in the Dark.
Here.
Skeptical Chemist.
Here.
Society of Physics Students. Saved You Up Till Dawn.
Here.
Student Alumni.
Here.
Student Athletic Advisory Committee. SAC.
Here.
Swing Club.
Here.
Taekwondo. Ultimate Frisbee.
Here.
Upscale.
Here.
Water Polo.
Here.
Wiffle Ball. Swimming Club. Yara.
Here.
Gospel Choir.
Here.
All right, I move to approve the minutes from last week's meeting.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Minutes approved. Officer reports. There will be a special session of the Student Senate in regards to April Easter break on Wednesday, March 9th at 8 p.m. in Manor Auditorium. It will be in an open forum style format, and President Riggs, Vice Provost Jack Ryan, Chaplain Joe Cavella, as well as Associate Provost and member of the Faculty Governance Committee, Rhonda Good, will be present. Later in new business, I'll be picking out the winner of Nessie Round 2 for the lucky prize of $200. Student College Review Board applications are due on Thursday, March 10th. I addressed the faculty this past Thursday, and last Monday, three senators and myself visited McDaniel Student Government Association. And also, have a wonderful spring break, and good luck in the next one.
See you too.
Thanks. Hey guys, thanks to everyone that responded so far to my email about election committee. I'll wait until a few more of those filter in, and then send an email to everyone that didn't respond, kind of plan of action about how we're going to go about it. So if I didn't respond to you, that's why I'm just waiting to give everyone a chance to check their email and see who's interested in that. And to look for an email from me in the next couple of days with the timeline of things. And that's it.
Hey guys, I just have a couple of quick reminders. I haven't been doing this for the past couple of weeks, but I should be. They're always in the midst too if you don't get there. But for clubs that come to request money from BMC for under $500, I do try and, when I remember, try and report that to the full Senate. So this week we had Allies came and requested $305, and they were granted that full amount. Some friends came and requested $225, and it was granted the full amount. Just a reminder. reminder that tomorrow night at 8 p.m. right here at Club 260, Senate's going to be having our student budgeting information session. So that's open again. Any member of campus, members of clubs, Senate reps, treasurers, presidents, anybody who's interested and wants to learn more about the process, shouldn't take any more than a half an hour to 45 minutes, depending on how many questions if there are. I'll be happy to take those throughout the entire session. And we're going to have cereal cookies and some snacks otherwise, so that's in the summer. Great, that's up there tomorrow too. Just another reminder that if you're coming to BMC to make requests, please email me your requests prior to your hearing. I still have a lot of clubs that are bringing paper copies of requests, and I really ask that for your sake and for everybody else's that you email those to me because it makes it easier on our part. And also for clubs who didn't come to the full Senate to request their preliminary budgets this semester, if you haven't received your base budget, which you're entitled to based off the current constitution, clubs need to contact me and I'll have that transferred into your account. Again, if you came and requested your semester budget, that was already included with your allocation, but if you haven't done that, if you didn't request an allocation at the beginning of the semester, please contact me and I'll transfer your base budget once I hear back from you. I don't do that automatically because we have a lot of clubs that don't need the base budget or aren't operating to the sense that they need it, so just to keep that in mind. That's everything.
Okay. Alright guys, just a few things. Please remember to update your club's leadership by April 15th. Again, I'm working on the website, so that information. The sooner you get that in, the better that's going to be, because everything on the website has to be up to date now. The GLC, the Garfield Leadership Center, is having the fourth workshop in the series. This Thursday, March 10th, from 7 to 8 p.m. in Masters 117. That'll be about conflict management, and Andrew Barclay, Director of Group Life, is going to be facilitating the discussion, so definitely show up to that, please. That'll be really good. Also, Get Acquainted Day. I think Kelly has been sending out the emails, but again, I just want to remind you guys, if you haven't yet contacted her, please do to request the table at Get Acquainted Day. That's a great way to do some PR for your club. All right, and Alex mentioned this event. I definitely recommend going up to that. And just the last thing, for next year, I'm going to be going off campus. So if anyone is interested in the position of club's liaison, please contact me. I know we talked about the elections coming up, but it's just a different position in the sense that you work in the Office of Student Activities, so you aren't paid employee of the office, so it's different than just an outright elected position. There's kind of like an application process, so if you are interested at all, freshmen, sophomores, juniors, seniors, anyone can apply. Well, obviously you're not seniors, but if you want to, you can, but submit a resume, cover letter to me, please, by email, and I'd be happy to talk about the position. It's just 8 office hours a week in the OSA, and then everything in the center as well. It's a great job, and I'd be happy to talk to other people, but please contact me if you're interested. Okay.
Yeah. Entry-level jobs, so 50,000 is 4 zeros. this chart, you basically see like the usage times Y, and it's updated for like basically 5 minutes, and it shows like from, this is from like I would say 4 to 8, the internet's free, nobody's really using it, and that's because so anybody can use these resources. So if you want to use, if you want to watch a movie, these are perfect times to like.
Operational costs each semester were far greater than what we normally have for Senate-recognized clubs organizations, which of course get $100 per semester. So as you can see from the minutes, this is the original minutes from February 18th or 17th of 2008. And the discussion was whether to grant Gettysburg TV this additional budget, which was to remain in effect pending the annual review. So as you can see, the Senate voted to allocate that $1,500, which was to be given out each semester, essentially for as long as Gettysburg TV would remain in existence, as long as this annual review provision was inserted in there. So last year when I was treasurer, I wasn't aware of this arrangement that the Senate had with Gettysburg TV. And when I came back to campus in January, Gettysburg TV brought up to me again and showed me the minutes so that I was aware that there was this agreement. And so I thought this would be a good time to take the full Senate to review this agreement that we have in place. So the BMC spent about half an hour, maybe 45 minutes tonight, talking with Dave and Ansgar and Stephanie, who came to present it. And so the request that we're going to hear tonight is not for a specific event and or equipment as we usually have. So this would be, and I'll leave it up to the Senate whenever we get to that. But so we're just going to have Ansgar talk a little bit about their organization, some of the more details about why they feel they need this additional base budget.
Hi, if you don't know me, my name is Ansgar Fossey. Can everyone hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. These are some other members of Gettysburg TV. I have a PowerPoint here, but I'm going to try to avoid that. But if any other questions come up, I can refer to that stuff. Okay, so Gettysburg TV has been around since 2006. Since then, we've worked with around 75 campus organizations. That ranges from athletics to lots of people in this room, different departments, academic departments on campuses, and many offices on campus as well. One of the central media organizations, and we collaborate with all the other media organizations and events, such as the Speak Up Right Up Journalism Conference. One thing that is unique about Gettysburg TV is that we are not affiliated with an academic department. In the Centennial Conference, there's one campus TV station that's one other campus TV station, that's McDaniel. They receive support from an academic department, a communications department at their school. We have a film department, but as of right now, it's one professor, so we don't exactly have the funds to support Gettysburg TV from that aspect. So the money that we receive in this budget is crucial for us to do what we're trying to do. Another thing also is that from the start, Gettysburg TV has been all about serving students on this campus in two ways. One, to collaborate with people like yourselves on your different events and different projects. And the other is bridging that gap between the classroom and actually learning video productions for people who are film students or people who are just interested in video production in general. So the request for the budget is $1,500 a semester, which is crucial for the growing of the station. The reasoning behind this was that one, so that Senate would not see us coming all the time asking for money, and two, that the equipment that we work with is often more expensive than most of the other clubs. The standard budget, as you all, of course, the standard base budget, as you all probably know, is $100. That doesn't even cover the amount of tapes that we would need for a semester. So this money is extremely crucial, and we're extremely grateful for it, of course. Let's see what else. Some notes about the semester. If we receive this money, we probably want to come to Senate for any more requests. $1,500 should be good for us. Another thing also is that it's helpful for us to have a friend at the beginning of the semester, because as we film events, it's good for us to just know what we're working with, because otherwise it could be difficult. We could go for a week where we run out of all sorts of supplies. But if we have all this money on the floor right in front of them, we can plan accordingly and use this money well. So, are there any other questions? Something else I would like to add is that the amount of people who have watched Gettysburg TV has grown immensely. As of today, we have around 175,000 hits on YouTube, and we also get compliments and comments from people all the time saying that they're happy that they see their friends on the fashion show or on the Ghost Hunter show or on the MJ show. So, yeah. On many shows. Yes.
What number is it? Can you get out of the
You can. It's channel 34. We also have a YouTube channel. And starting on Wednesday, we'll also be broadcasting from 11 to 1. So you can check us out there.
Well, how close do you guys come to spending that? Like last semester, how close to that number did you guys get?
We spent it. We put in some other requests last year, last semester, because some of our equipment is very old and it was just falling apart. So we had to replace that.
Motion to allot
$1,500
grant
annual. Hold on, roll call. I want to just discuss the motion.
Yes.
Alex, what was BMC's recommendation on this?
BMC took into consideration the fact that in the past 2 years, Gettysburg TV has come to Senate for supplemental requests of anywhere between $5,000 and $10,000 per year. So we think that because our system is designed to give clubs and organizations flexibility to request funds whenever they decide that they have an event or an activity or a program or a piece of equipment that they need, that the clubs, all clubs don't necessarily need a higher base budget. So we we came to the agreement that we think that $1,000 per semester is sufficient for GBIR TV to cover their costs as we understand them per semester, again, with the caveat of the annual review. So we think that it's difficult for us to make cuts in the sense that we review other requests, but we felt that $1,500 was a little bit too high considering that there's lots of new initiatives going on with GBIR TV, A, and B, that they already come to Senate for a significant amount of funds in addition to what they give on their base budget every year. So our recommendation is $1,000 per semester for as many, I mean, there's no specified end date, but with the caveat of the annual review, the Senate determined to review that with the BMC.
Yes.
So even if you did do the 1,000, they could still come and request that $500 anyways?
Right.
It would just take extra steps to do it?
Right. It would be the same as any other club that gets $100 for their base budget. If a club can operate on $100 per semester, that's okay, and they're free to do that. But again, every club that comes to request a base budget, 9 times out of 10, also comes for additional requests. So the point of the base budget is not to give a club all the money they can operate for a semester, but to give them something to start from in the semester and throughout, that they don't have to come to Senate.
I'm sorry, I'm just confused. Like, it just seems like such a small difference
between the 1,000 and the 2,000. Can you explain,
like, why?
Well, like I said, it's difficult to, since base budgets are designed to be flexible and that clubs don't come to request a base budget for a set amount of purposes. So I can't tell you that we made cuts based on we felt that this agreement should have been lower, that they should do less of an amount than what they requested, but we felt that considering our request process that the extra $1,000 per year, which would be GBIR TV continuing to get $3,000 in base budget per year, we felt that $3,000 was too much to essentially give to GBIR TV without any oversight of what supplementary funds would be spent. So as a middle ground between what some committee members were saying, we came to the agreement that $1,000 was sufficient.
And so how much do you guys spend on just like
the basis? Gosh.
Yeah, I can comment on this. Since coming, most of the supplements that we come for are actually for like upgrading our systems. Like eventually we'll want to go live, want to go tapeless cameras. The $1,500 that we receive each semester is pretty much for like the basic repairs we need, all the tapes, like the equipment, DVDs, all the essentials come from that $1,500.
We pretty much use it all. To answer your question, yeah.
Do you guys have any insurance?
For this semester, though, we're in good shape. We do have some repairs that have to take place, and we do provide tapes in some cases.
Jake, the review that we're talking about, would that be in this kind of form, or would it be in a different, would you just the BMC review?
Well, as you can see from the original minutes, it wasn't specified which part of Senate should review that, so we took it as we were going to, Exec decided on Wednesday that we were going to have the BMC review this first and spend a greater amount of time on the parts that we normally do. And then we would present this before the full Senate. Essentially, we could possibly recommend a change to the original policy, which is why we thought it was best to bring it before the full Senate. But that can also be specified in the motion, too, who's in charge of reviewing that. That's up to whoever makes the motion for the future. Again, the current agreement doesn't specify that, so we interpreted that to the best of our ability.
So you like think that the funding that you receive is something crucial to your student program? That's why
absolutely.
Right?
Could, yeah.
So my question is, why not then should you have to go through the same funding process? Because I understand, you know, it's hard to get it throughout the year, but every semester the club has the opportunity to submit a budget for the entire year that does include things other than the base budget. So why shouldn't GBIR TV just go through that process and get the money that way when it's still people voting on it the same? Why should it be a base budget where it doesn't have to say what it's spent? Right?
I might sound repetitive here, but it is two things. One are the stuff just costs more, so that's one thing. And the other thing is that we do provide a service to a significant population on campus community. And I think that justifies it as well.
Is there a motion over?
Yes. The motion is now to renew the contract at $1,500 pending annual review.
Alex, there's your report.
motion that it has to be brought to the full Senate. So you're voting on the stipulation that the $1,500, renew the contract, and the annual review goes before the full Senate. The motion to amend does not need a Senate.
How long is it? A year.
So you're voting for $1,500 per semester and the annual review before the full Senate next spring 2012. Secretary Krinsick, please call the roll.
Nick Redman.
Aye.
Alex Ferraro.
Nay.
Mike Krinsick. Aye. Laura Block.
Yes.
Carolyn Dooley.
Aye.
Casey Garvey Hall.
Yes.
Charles Meehan. Kevin Schmidt.
Nay.
Kevin Schmidt. Victoria Shepherd. Ellen Shue.
Nay.
Bill Smith.
Yes.
Robbie Egan.
Yes.
Sam Alum.
Yeah.
Amber Strange.
Yes.
Caroline Aiken.
Yes.
Carolyn Plank.
Yes.
Julie Weiss.
Yes.
Ryan Woodward.
Aye.
George Caswell.
Yes.
David DeBoer.
Abstain.
Scott Rivera.
Yes.
Candace Lopez.
Yes.
Kevin Lugo.
Yes.
Shereen Nayak.
Yeah.
Abderrahman.
Aye.
Patrick Hill.
Aye.
Mariah Johnson.
Aye.
Anthony Tomaski.
Yes.
Sean Moran.
Yes.
Dr. Perry.
Yes.
John Price.
Yes.
Fred Stewart.
Mr. Parliamentarian, let's get down. Motion to enter closed session.
Second.
All those in favor?